He wears number 0 on the court, not as a tribute to Russell Westbrook or Kevin Love, but as a symbolic reminder of what he's had to prove his entire life.
For me, it was a little bit tough trying to get recruited. Most of it came on the AAU circuit.
Harrison Cleary went to Oak Creek High School in Wisconsin, but wasn't able to get himself on the college radar until he faced national-level competition.
De'Aaron Fox is in the league now. Malik Monk, Jason Tatum, Shamori Ponds. I mean, the list goes on. There was some huge-name guys in that league.
I didn't see him play a ton in the summertime because his team played in some places we quite frankly didn't recruit to. But you get talking to coaches, you get talking, watching film on the computer.
What head coach Dan Weiss saw was a kid with massive potential. And with the relative lack of success Minnesota Crookston had seen on the court in recent years, he didn't hesitate to make a move, even when no one else was threatening him.
It doesn't matter to me who offers a kid or who doesn't. I know what I see. I was surprised that no one else did offer.
I had a lot of coaches calling me and texting me and stuff like that, but ultimately, offers didn't necessarily pour in like that. You know, I don't know if disappointing is the word, but it's a little maybe disheartening. Like, you put in all this work and you think you're playing really good basketball, and, you know, the offers aren't coming like you might think they should.
Up until the waning moments of signing day, Minnesota Crookston was Harrison's only choice. But a late push created some internal conflict.
South Carolina Aiken came to me really late in the process, actually about like 2 weeks before signing day in November. So that kind of set me back. I was kind of really sold on Crookston, and then South Carolina Aiken came and gave me an offer. And I kind of had to rethink things for a little bit, but ultimately decided to go with Crookston before that signing day.
The initial faith from Coach Weiss paid off, and he could tell right away that Harrison Cleary would immediately clear the skies raining down on Crookston's parade.
Big chip on his shoulder, had something to prove. And you know what, he still has that same chip, and he still has something to prove every day in practice to this day, and that's what makes him tick.
I knew I could play at a very high level, so for Crookston to believe that as well meant a lot. Coach Weiss and Coach Beamish really believed that I could be great, and they wanted me to prove it here. So it meant a lot that they believed in me, and you know, I wanted to make it happen.
Harrison scored 34 points in his very first collegiate game. It was one thing to dominate a relatively empty gym in practice, but to do it when it counted was another confidence boost.
So right away I was like, okay, you know, I can really be successful here. And like I said, coach believed in me and the team believed in me, and they kind of just, you know, put it on my shoulders and said, you know, we're going to follow you. So from then on, I kind of knew that I could be really successful at this level.
In his first three seasons at Minnesota Crookston, Harrison's already become the school's all-time leading scorer with more than 2,000 career points. His offensive outburst attracted some of the attention he had been craving since high school, and it felt like he was being recruited all over again, this time to transfer.
It crosses your mind. Especially with the success I've had, I definitely had some other suitors that, you know, I could have went and played at. But at the end of the day, loyalty is big. And at the same time, you know, I appreciate what Coach Weiss and Coach Beamish have done for me here.
Does it go through your head? Sure it does. But, you know, hopefully maybe that says something that he likes to play for us, our coaching staff. I think he's got a great, great bond with his teammates. You know, he's got teammates that'll run through a wall for him, and he'd do the same for them.
Minnesota Crookston is coming off a career season on the court. They finished with an above 500 record and won their first ever NSIC tournament game, knocking off Augustana in Sioux Falls.
I think people are starting to realize that Crookston's for real. You know, beating Augustana, that's a huge feat. They're a great team, and especially in a tournament like that, on their home court, you know, all things considered, I think it just kind of cemented the fact that, you know, we're a legitimate contender, and that you can't really sleep on us anymore.
Having Harrison come in, you could see the culture of the program turn a little bit. And now, of course, we're hungry for more. Beating Augustana can help hopefully keep us going in the direction we want to go to.
The season ended a few days later at the Sanford Pentagon, falling to Winona State in the conference tournament quarterfinals. But with Harrison back for his senior season, he wants to continue making the biggest impact in order to leave an even bigger imprint.
People are excited to watch Crookston play basketball now, where that hasn't even been the case, you know, my freshman and sophomore year. I think it's becoming more of a thing where, you know, people are excited to come see us and see what we can do every night.
We're lucky to have him. We're thankful to have him. He's elevated the program. I'm so thankful I get him for 1 year. But when he does leave here, we certainly want to keep that upward trajectory, and that's what we're going to try to do.